Hello, hello, good evening.
Good evening.
Hey there, welcome. Welcome everybody. Nice to see, well, Julie connected. Lucy, nice.
Good evening.
Hello, good evening, Marilyn, Vilma, Evelyn, Emilio, Angel, Meli.
Hello.
Anita, hello, hello. Welcome. Okay, guys, really nice to have you here. As always, a pleasure. And well, let's get down to business. Today we're going to be, well, dealing with, we're going to study in, let's say, depth, a topic that we mentioned at some point, but that we haven't studied, I guess, with, with like pretty much all the rules that it has, right? So let's see. First things first, let's take attendance and then we start here. So let me see. Okay, so here we go. Just one second. Here. Okay, then. So then we start with Alison Gabriela Ramos, not here. Then we have Ana Beatriz Pineda.
Hello.
Hello. Welcome, Anita. Then we have Angel Balmore Aguilar.
Present.
Thank you very much, Angel. Nice. Then we have Brenda Raquel Reyes, who I guess is not here. So then we continue with Glenda Maricela Cuellar. Glenda, not here yet. So then we continue with Iris Beatriz Cornejo.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much. Iris, nice. Then we have Josué Vladimir Alvarenga. Josué. Not there? No. All right, so not there. So then we continue with Carla Maria Beatriz Arana. Carla Maria, I guess she's not connected yet. So next person, Carla Yesenia Lanza. Carlita Lanza, not there. So then we move on to Lucy Natalie Juarez.
Here, teacher.
Thank you very much, Lucy. Nice. So next person, Marilyn Del Carmen Solis.
Hi, teacher. Present.
Hello, Marilyn. Nice. Nice to have you here. So excellent. So then we have a Mauricio Emilio Alvarenga.
The present, teacher.
All right. Thank you very much, Mauricio. Next person, Obed Alexander Alas.
Here, teacher.
Thank you very much, Obed. Nice. Next, we have Orfa Lizeth Barrera. I guess not connected yet. So, next person, Rosa Vilma Landaverde.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Vilma. Nice. Next person, Sonia Evelyn Iraeta.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Evelyn. Evelyn pudo entrar a la plataforma ahora.
Ah, sí.
Sí,
anoche lo hice.
Ah, super, super. Nice.
Sí,
nice.
Meli me ayudó. Me orientó.
Nah, le funcionó, sí, lo que le pusieron en el chat.
Sí, eso era.
Ah, chivísimo, nice.
Sí,
perfecto.
Todo, bueno, muy amable, gracias.
Me alegro, excelente, gracias a todos entonces por el apoyo, por el soporte técnico.
Sí.
Nice, good.
Eso.
All right, nice. Let's see, next person then, we have Teresa Guadalupe Bonilla. Teresa, not here, okay. So next person then, Jessica Melissa Oya.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Meli, nice. And last but not least, we have Julissa Raquel Cruz.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Julie. Okay, then. Wonderful.
Hi, teacher. Vine un poquito tarde, ya estoy aquí.
Let me see, Josué.
Josué.
Ay, ni modo, ya le cayó falta, Josué.
Va, de acuerdo.
De acuerdo. No, just kidding, Josué. That's fine. That's okay.
Sorry, ahí está.
ahí está, Josué. Don't worry. Let's see, por ahí vi que se conectó alguien más. Okay. Let's see, Carla María. Let's see. Nice. Very good. Quiero ver. Nice. There's another person there. No, ¿verdad? Creo que sí estamos. Okay. Nice. All right then. So let's get down to business. Let's start with today's class. Let's see. So, all right. So the first thing today, we're going to be talking a little bit about a frequency adverbs or adverbs of frequency, as we prefer to call them. So we're going to review some of the rules for the use of frequency adverbs in daily activities. So I have here a video about these frequency adverbs. So let's see. There you go. Let me share my screen so that we can watch it. Here we go. Okay, let's start first watching this video. Then I'm going to explain to you a couple of things about the adverbs of frequency. And then we're going to have a couple of practices to review this topic. So here we go. Let's pay attention to the video first, and then I'll explain to you a couple of things. Here we go.
ESL Library. Adverbs of frequency. What are adverbs? Adverbs can do many things in a sentence. They can describe verbs, adjectives, other adverbs, or entire sentences. Adverbs of frequency tell us how often an action takes place. For example, my dog is always sleepy. Our teacher often gives us homework. I can never remember his name. What are some common adverbs of frequency in English? What do they mean? An easy way to remember the meaning of frequency adverbs is to match them with percentages. How often do you do something? When talking about frequency, 100% means you do something all the time. 0% means you don't ever do it. The adverb always means 100%. Almost always means about 95%. The adverbs usually and often mean about 80%. Sometimes means around 50%. The adverbs seldom and not very often mean about 20%. Rarely means around 10%. Almost never means about 5%. The adverb never means 0%. There are three common sentence patterns for adverbs of frequency in English. The first pattern is be plus adverb. For example, in the sentence, she is never late, the adverb never follows the verb is. Never describes how often she is late. The second pattern is adverb plus verb. For example, in the sentence, we usually eat lunch in the cafeteria, the adverb usually comes before the verb eat. Usually describes how often we eat lunch in the cafeteria. The third pattern is verb plus adverb plus verb. When a verb has two or more parts, the frequency adverb usually follows the first part of the verb. For example, in the sentence, "You are always looking at your phone," the adverb always comes between are and looking. Always describes how often you are looking at your phone. Let's look at some more examples of adverbs of frequency in a sentence. It is almost always cold in this room. He is often sick. My friends usually laugh a lot. It rarely rains in summer in my hometown. I can sometimes hear birds in my backyard. My mother is always telling me what to do. Look at the picture and unscramble the words to make a sentence. Say or write the sentence. For example,
all right. What about this one? How do you think it should be the correct order here? Volunteer. No volunteers. Democráticamente, let's see. Carla Maria, nice.
I think if he rarely goes to the gym.
All right, so he rarely goes to the gym. Let's see, would that be?
He goes to the gym.
Excellent, there you go. So wonderful. Here we have, we're going to talk a little bit about the order of frequency adverbs in a bit. But nice, good job, excellent. What about,
try.
Let me see, here we have another one. What do you think it should be the right order? Let's see, another volunteer. Let me see, tienen frío los voluntarios ahora, let me see. So I guess, Millie.
Okay. I can never remember her name.
I can never remember her name. Let's see if that would be. Let's see. Yes, very good. I can never remember her name. Excellent. So let's see, another example. What about this one? Let's see. This one goes to Lucy.
Hi.
Hi there.
I always sing in the shower.
Something's missing.
Almost I always sing in the shower.
Almost I always close. This one, the adverb is almost always.
Almost always. Always, I almost sing in the shower.
No, it's almost always together.
Okay. Almost always, I sing in the shower.
Almost always, I sing in the shower. Let's see, would that be the order? And Almost. So I almost always sing in the shower. Whenever we add almost, we can do it to almost never or almost always, for example. And it is to express that, as we say in Spanish, casi siempre, right? O casi nunca, if it goes with never. So that is what this word almost means. So, but good. There you go. Let's see this one here. Let me see. What do you think? So what's the correct order here? Angel.
Hi, teacher.
Hey there, Angel.
They are.
Huh?
They are hard wash. Laughing.
Huh? They are always laughing. Let's see if that's the correct order. They are always laughing. Yes, very good. So they are always laughing. Nice. Thank you very much, Angel. Okay, then. Now that we started something related to frequency adverbs, let me explain to you some of the rules that they already mentioned there. But let's go little by little. Let's go part by part as Jack the Ripper here. So adverbs of frequency. What are precisely adverbs of frequency? They are very much words that they help us to express how often we do or not do certain activities. So if you remember, we mentioned something about frequency adverbs some days ago. We didn't dedicate too much time to it, but today we're gonna do it. Here we have an example on how to use them. Like when we say, they often go out for dinner. If you remember, each frequency adverb has like a certain percentage. The lists of frequency adverbs, they might change. So there might be some that are added here that maybe were not in the video. And well, or vice versa, right? This depends on the source. However, in this one that we have here, we can see some of the most common frequency adverbs that we might find out there, in the real world, right? That are used in real English. So frequency adverbs start from 0 to 100%. That 0%, remember, starts with never. Yeah, so an example here, vegetarians never eat meat. So that means they don't do that, basically. Then we have hardly ever. We can use here hardly ever, rarely, or as we were saying before, almost never. Either of the three words is going to give me the same idea, that this is almost, or that this happens almost at all, right? So it's just a 5% of it. Then we have seldom. Seldom is something in between, let's say 10, 15%, right? So for example, I seldom put salt on my food. So not something that I do very often, yep. Same happens with occasionally. Then we reach this, that is the middle, 50%, which is sometimes. Sometimes, well, we have like 3 points, 0, 50%, and 100%. The ones that are in between, sometimes they are very relative. And they are not very precise. But those 3 points there, they are the fundamentals, right? The frequency adverbs, because they are clearly stated as 0, 50, and 100%. So Sometimes it's going to be one of our cornerstones here in the 50%. Then we have often or frequently. Teacher, puedo decir often, es que ya has escuchado también. Sí, right, puede ser often, puede ser often. It's the same. So, with frequently, they shared the 70%. Right next to it, we have normally and generally. Normally, generally, they are considered also adverbs of frequency. They are not included in some lists of frequency adverbs, but they are also expressions that are used. They express more or less an 80%. Then we have usually, right? Usually, something that I do almost always, almost every day. I usually, right? So I usually walk to work. Maybe not, but I usually work from home. That's something that I could say. So there you go. Then we have always, as I said before, it's one of the easiest ones because, well, it's pretty much the 100% things that we do all the time. Something to keep in mind. Teacher, y entonces puedo tirar esos frequency adverbs así como caigan en la oración? No, right? Tienen un orden. They have a specific order. And how do I know the order? Is it because of the frequency adverb? No, it depends more on the verb. If I am using a, let's say, an action verb, let me write it here. So if I'm using an act, Jesus Christ, an action verb, there you go. So I would say something like, I usually have dinner, let's say, at 7 p.m. Si no, me desmayo. There you go. I usually have dinner at 7 p.m. Now, what's the order here? If you notice, I'm using an action verb. I have dinner. So where is it going to go then? Before the verb. Before, to be precise, my action verb. What happens if I have the verb to be? Is it going to be the same? No. If I have the verb to be, then this is going to change a bit. So I would say something like, what? Uy, un nombre que no esté aquí. Laura. Laura is usually, or let's say, is always late for work. So Laura is always late for work. In this case, I am not using the frequency adverb before my verb. Why? Because I'm using the verb to be. With the verb to be, we have a special, let's say, treatment whenever we talk about frequency adverbs, and we place the adverb after any form of the verb to be. So I can say, for example, I am I am usually awake at, let's say, 11 p.m. I am usually awake at 11 p.m. So not all the time, usually. There are some times in which I just fall asleep like that. 10:30, 10:45, et cetera, et cetera. But usually I'm awake at 11 p.m. So one more time. It doesn't matter the form of the verb to be, because I can use it with is, with are, with am, no matter. I'm going to use the frequency adverb after the verb. Same happens with an action verb. If I have an action verb, Doesn't matter what action verb I'm using, it's going to go before. There you go. En el video mencionaban una tercera regla con respecto a la ubicación de los adverbios. Do you remember that third rule? What did they say? Ajá.
Verb, adverb, and verb.
Ah, very good. Excellent. Verb, adverb, and verb again. Do you remember the example they provided? No, not exactly. Don't remember. Okay, no. Anybody who remembers? Somebody else? No. Okay. So this one is a very particular structure. We can see this with more complex tenses, like for example, the present continuous. We're going to study the present continuous, not today, but we're going to study it during these days. So I'm going to give you a taste of it. For example, this is when we have Josh is rarely what? It's rarely speaking about his brother. Josh is rarely speaking about his brother. So here I can see how to use or how to insert the frequency adverb in a tense that is not the simple present, for example. So when I'm using the present continuous, I use the verb to be and the verb in the ing. So I have, it's like if I have two verbs. Now, if I have something like the present continuous, past continuous, or the present perfect, in which we also use that, we are going to use this pattern, or we're going to follow this pattern. He's rarely speaking about his brother. Another example could be, let's say, Mary has never visited something easier, Germany. Mary has never visited Germany. Here we have another example. This is another tense that uses verb, adverb, verb. This is the present perfect. So I'm going to type it here, present perfect. So this is an example with the present continuous. So there you go. So in a nutshell, I use the present continuous to talk about actions that are happening right now. Like Josh is rarely speaking about his brother, but now maybe he is speaking about him. Then we have the present perfect. The present perfect, I use it to talk about experiences. So Mary has never visited Germany. One more time, I have a verb, auxiliary verb has, plus verb in the past participle form. This is the present perfect. This is like when we say in Spanish, Mary nunca ha visitado Alemania. Of course, we change the order of the elements of the sentence in Spanish. All right, so we say, nunca ha visitado. But in English, we would say, she has never visited Germany. Mm-hmm. All right, questions so far? Clear as crystal. Okay, or clear as the night. All right, let's see. So, Carla Maria, you have a question. Let's see.
solo se da en estos dos casos, se da esta, teacher, del verbo, verbo y verbo, o hay más. Estos son dos ejemplos.
Son dos ejemplos de tiempos en los que podría pasar.
Pero tal ahí pueden haber otros casos.
Sí, si lo vemos tal vez a manera más general, podríamos decir que cuando nos va a pasar esto son tiempos continuos, que serían el pasado continuo, el presente continuo, el futuro continuo, o tiempos perfectos, como el past perfect, present perfect, o future perfect. ¿Por qué con estos dos tipos de tiempo? Porque son los que llevan auxiliar más un cachito más, un verbo modificado de alguna manera.
Thank you, teacher.
Nice, anytime. All right, so very good. Now, let me see that we clarify this. We can continue and we can check some examples. So, here you have is something that I was explaining to you before. If the, let's say that the sentence has just one verb, right? You're not going to complicate that much. This makes reference to an action verb, to be specific. Like in the example that we have here, Tom usually goes to work by car. So we use usually before the verb here because we have an action verb, not the verb to be. So same happens here. Janet never flies. She always goes by bus. Same pattern, no changes. Then we have some examples with the verb to be. As we said, this is going to be somehow special, right? So we say, I am never late for work. So we're going to invert the order. First the verb, then the frequency adverb. Peter is often at school. Same thing. Frequency adverb right after the verb to be. All the time. And let me see. These are some more examples. And this is what we were talking about, like the structure that we were saying, a verb, adverb, verb. This can happen as well. Si ocupo un auxiliar como can, no necesariamente va a ser un tiempo perfecto, un tiempo continuo, pero también podría darse de que ocupe un auxiliar como can o could o would, right? En los que no va solo el auxiliar, sino que también va otro verbo. Como acá, I can never remember anything. So I have can as an auxiliary verb, but I also have remember as the main verb. So where am I going to place the frequency adverb? Bam, right in the middle, right? So we're gonna make a sandwich in this case with the frequency adverb. Whenever we have auxiliary plus verb. Creo que la regla, para dejarlo un poco más claro, quizás podríamos dejarla en no verlo como el tiempo, que si es perfecto, que si es continuo, sino más bien, siempre que tenga auxiliar y verbo principal, porque acuérdense acá, no son dos verbos principales, ¿verdad? Sino que siempre uno va a ser un auxiliar y el otro, usualmente el segundo, es el verbo principal, el que modifica el primero, que es el auxiliar. Y ahí, en medio, el frequency adverb. There you go. All right. If it was a question, we have, when using adverbs of frequency in the question or negative form, put the adverb of frequency before the main verb. So it could happen that we don't use the frequency adverb just with affirmative statements. We can also use it with negative statements and questions. So if it's negative, she doesn't often visit Europe. Lo mismo, se cumple lo de el auxiliar, más la negación, el adverbio y el verbo, right? So pretty much the same. In the question, it's going to change a little bit. In questions, you think about this rule. Frequency adverb is going to go before the verb, if it's a question. Like in this case, do you usually get up early? Do you usually, right? Frequency adverb before the verb in questions. So there you go. And let's see. Well, here we have some examples, but I have my own examples for you. So let me see. Any questions so far? Vamos bien? Todo nice? Good. Okay. So if you have no questions, I do have questions for you. So let's see. Here we have a little roulette, let's say, or a wheel, in which I have some questions. Uy, me dan miedo estos anuncios que salen de repente. Anyway, so I have these questions that I'm going to spin the wheel, and you're going to answer the question that actually appears here. I'm going to select a person to answer. So let's see how this goes. You try to use frequency adverbs in the right order. So let's see. First question goes to, let me see, Vilma. You ready, Vilma?
Ready, teacher.
Okay, excellent. That's the spirit. So let's see what's the question for Vilma here. And all right, let's see, Izzy. How often do you listen to music, Vilma?
¿Qué dice, teacher?
¿Qué tan a menudo? Subtítulo, subtítulo. ¿Qué tan a menudo escucha música?
Ay, no, por mí todo el día escuchará música.
Nice. So you listen to music like always, almost always. Usually,
sí.
How would you say? ¿Cómo lo diría? Ajá. Don't worry,
no se quiere dormir.
Ajá, no me quiere que esté en la clase.
Vaya, dice. Tengo que repetir, dice, la ordenada, no, como, perdón.
You have to answer the question. Tiene que responderla. Según lo que acabamos de ver, con un adverbio de frecuencia. Por ejemplo, si me preguntaran a mí eso, yo diría, I usually listen to music. What about you?
Okay. Ay, no sé. Sí, escucho música todo el día casi.
So I always
sería siempre, ¿verdad? Bastante.
Exactly.
Siempre. I always
listen to music. There you go. So I always listen to music. Nice. Good. Very good. So let's see. Nice. Okay, there you go. So let's see. Yo también tengo una niña y a veces viene aquí, pero no se dan cuenta. Yo me quedo así como que no pasa nada. So let's see. So next question goes to Evelyn. Evelyn, are you there? Evelyn. All right. Let's see. Oh my God, I've been with polls today. Okay, so let's see.
No encontraba el botón.
Nice, don't worry. So this question goes for you, Evelyn. Let's see. So we have, how often do you eat at a restaurant?
I rarely eat at a restaurant.
There you go. So I rarely eat at a restaurant. Nice. What's your favorite restaurant, Evelyn? Do you have a favorite restaurant?
I like La Bucanera.
Which one?
I like La Bucanera.
Oh, Clavo y Canela, there you go. The parrillada, Clavo y Canela is delicious, right? Nice, very good.
Yes.
So, excellent. Thank you very much, Evelyn. Nice. Okay. Let's see. Evelyn, you select another person.
Okay. ¿Qué tal? Lucy.
Let's see, Lucy.
Hello.
Hey there, Lucy. So this question goes for you. Let's see. Ah, no, same question. No, let's see, one more time. Let's see. Oh my God, really? Está sobada la ruleta, wey. Amaña. Let's see. All right, there you go. So, how often do you go abroad?
What means abroad, teacher?
Abroad, it means when you travel to a different country.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
Well, I never go for abroad.
Never go abroad.
No.
Same here. Same case. All right. Nice. So, no plans for traveling? No. No. Oh my. So when you have vacation, do you go somewhere outside the city in El Salvador? What do you do on vacation?
Go for with my family to the cities nearby.
To the cities nearby. Very good. Okay, excellent. All right. So thank you very much. Can you select another person, Lucy?
Angel.
Angel, let's see. Angel.
Hi.
Hey, Angel. So this question goes for you. Let's see. Angel, really? No, let's see another question. Let's see, Jesus Christ, simple. But anyway, so Angel, how often do you listen to music?
Always.
So yes. You always listen to music.
Yes, I always listen to music.
All right, good. And what type of music do you like to listen?
It is Eminem rap.
And, oh my God, there you go. Really? Nice. What's your favorite song by Eminem?
Thank you, teacher.
What's your favorite song?
Singer for the Moment.
Oh, that's a good one. It's a very nice song. Okay, excellent. Thank you very much then, Angel.
Okay, so teacher.
You choose another person.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
One moment.
Sure.
Sonia Iraeta.
Another person, ya pasó, Evelyn.
Emilio.
Emilio, let's see. Emilio,
okay.
All right, Emilio, let's see. This question goes for you. So we have, how often do you go to the cinema, Emilio?
The cinema. After the cinema and the night.
Uh-huh.
On the night, I'm not frequenting.
Uh-huh. How would you answer this using a frequency adverb? Like usually, okay. Sometimes.
I often
uh-huh.
I often in the
go
in
to
the morning the now frequently.
I often go to the cinema.
I not frequently.
So you often go to the cinema at night on Wednesdays?
Yeah.
Oh, I see. Very good. Nice. So you go to Cinemark. Yes?
Yes.
Okay, there you go. Nice. Very good.
Yes.
What type of movies do you like? Action, comedy, horror?
In the comedy.
Comedies, all right, comedies. Very good. All right, nice, Emilio. Excellent. So you select another person.
Carla Lanza ya pasó, ¿verdad?
No, no ha pasado.
Va. Entonces ahí ya
okay. So let's see.
La primera que aparece.
Nice. Carlita Lanza. Let's see. You're ready, Carlita.
Ready.
Okay, excellent. So this question goes for you, Carlita. Huh. What about this one? How often do you go outside the city, Carlita?
Always.
Always.
Always. No sé cómo se dice, estoy fuera de la ciudad.
I am always
uh-huh. Outside the city.
Oh my, why? Because of your work.
Yes.
Oh my
god. I'm working in the project. Usually. In this case, uh-huh. I live in my house in Santa Rosa de Lima. It's
wow.
Always the city.
Jesus. In what cities do you visit more often?
Can you repeat the question, please?
Sure. What cities do you visit more often?
San Miguel and uh-huh. San Salvador.
Oh, I see. All right. Wow. So you travel a little bit far.
Yes.
Sometimes. Okay. Nice. Okay. Thank you very much for that, Carlita. So you select another person.
Julie? Ya pasó Julie.
Let's see. Julie? No.
Hello.
So let's see.
Hi, Julie.
Okay. Julie, are you ready?
Lista.
Okay, Julie, this question goes for you. Let's see. No, same question, another one. the same question, the music, no. Oh my God, you know.
We need to change the app.
Ah, yes, I guess. Está desnivelada la ruleta. Quizás es el piso acá de mi casa. Jesus, you see the same questions. But anyway, let's go for this one. So, Julie, how often do you eat at a restaurant?
I rarely.
Rarely?
A restaurant.
All right, there you go. And when you go to a restaurant, where do you go? What do you like to eat? What do you like to eat? When you go out, what do you eat? Chicken, pizza, roast beef.
Pues de todo. Pizza, pollo.
Chicken. Chinese food. All right. So a little bit of everything. We would say in English, a little bit of everything. Un poquito de todo, right? A little bit of everything. There you go. All right, nice. So thank you very much. Julie, select one more person. Julie.
Obed.
Obed, let's see. No, no ha pasado. So let's see. Obed, you ready?
Yes.
Okay, Obed. This question goes for you. All right. So let's see. Let's go for this one. How often do you go to the cinema, Obed?
Usually the Friday in the night.
Oh, so usually you go to the cinema. You usually go to the cinema on Friday's nights.
Yes.
Oh, good. And what are your favorite types of movies?
Superhero.
Ah, so you like Marvel, DC movies. Yes. What's your favorite superhero movie?
I like the Avengers.
Avengers, uh-huh. Oh,
nice. The whole series of Avengers.
Good. Nice. Did you watch Eternals already?
No, not yet. But I hope watch it this week.
All right, this week. Excellent. Pero después de la clase. Obed.
Yeah.
Nice. Very good. Okay, Obed. Thank you very much for that. Good. Okay, then. So there you go. Just here some examples or some practical uses of frequency adverbs. Whenever we're talking, it's a little bit more difficult to remember the order of the adverbs. Cuando vamos a contestar, bueno, cuando lo hacemos de manera oral, y de pronto no escatimamos mucho en el orden del adverbio, ¿no? Lo que queremos es transmitir la idea, which is okay, but try to remember the rules, right? So if I ask, for example, how often do you read a book? I sometimes read books, right? I sometimes read books, yeah, etc., etc. So that's pretty much it. Now, it's almost 9. Voy a tomar la asistencia ya. Y antes de pasar a la siguiente actividad para que no nos quedemos a medias. So, wait. Ay, Jesus. No, you know what? I'm just going to do it like this. Okay, so here we go. So I start with Alison Gabriela Ramos. Not here. So I have Ana Beatriz Pineda.
Present.
Thank you very much. Anita, next, Ángel Balmore Aguilar.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much. Angel, next, Brenda Raquel Reyes. Creo que no está acá. So, next person, Glenda Marisela Cuellar. Glenda not here, all right. So I continue with Iris Beatriz Cornejo.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Iris. Next, I have Josue Vladimir Alvarenga.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much. Josh, next person, Carla Maria Beatriz Arana.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Carla Maria. Next person, Carla Yesenia Lanza.
Present.
Thank you very much, Carlita. Y next I have Lucy Natalie Juarez.
Hi, here.
All right, thank you very much, Lucy. Then I have Marilyn Del Carmen Solis.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Marilyn. Nice. Next person, Mauricio Emilio Alvarenga.
Hello, present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Mauricio. Next, Obed Alexander Alas.
Here, teacher.
Thank you very much, Obed. Nice. Then I have Orfa Lisette Barrera. Orfa, not here. So I continue with Rosa Vilma Landa Verde.
Present.
Thank you very much, Vilma. So next person, I have Sonia Evelyn Iraeta.
Present.
Thank you very much, Evelyn. Next, Teresa Guadalupe Bonilla, creo que no está acá. So then I have Jessica Melissa Oya.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Meli. And last but not least, Julissa Raquel Cruz.
Present, teacher.
All right, thank you very much. Okay then, so just as another practice here, in terms of the order of frequency adverbs, let's see if you remember how to put these frequency adverbs in the correct order. So here we go. What are we going to do then? We're going to play. Let me see. We're going to play a jumble Kahoot so that we can check if we actually can identify where to put the frequency adverb in a sentence. So this is the pin number we're going to use. So let's see. All right. Este Kahoot va a ser de ordenar la oración, ¿ok? No de seleccionar la respuesta correcta, sino de y poner la oración en el orden correcto. So, let's see. Here we have Iris, Millie, Vilma. Lucy, good. Julie, nice. Anita, Carla María, Josué. Obed. Evelyn, nice. Carlita Lanza. Emilio. Okay, then. Let's see. Let's start with this activity. So if you haven't been able to join, you can join during the game, all right? Se puede incorporar durante el juego. So don't worry. So let's see, let's start with number one. So here we go, puzzle. Put the words in the correct order here. remember the rules. Let's see. And 5 more seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's see. So I always study in the afternoon. So here we have an action verb, not the verb to be, action verb. So I have the verb study. So if I have an action verb, remember, I bring the frequency adverb before the action verb, not later. Tampoco puedo decir always I study, right? Or I study in the afternoon, always. Mm-mm. In Spanish, we do that a lot. Yo estudio en la tarde, siempre. Nah, but in English, no way, Jose. So let's see. All right, positions. Meli, first place. Yuli, Carla Maria, Lanza, and Ovid. Next one. What about this one? What about this one? So 5 seconds, 4, 3, 2, 1. So here we have same situation. We have an action verb, watch. So we say, we never watch movies in the morning. There you go. Let's see. All right, so we have Meli still in the first place, Carla Maria going up, y Carlita Lanza going up, Julie and Ove. Next one here. Breakfast. And 3, 2, 1. There you go. So they usually have breakfast at 7. One more time, have breakfast, action verb. So they usually have breakfast at 7. There you go. All right, Evelyn going up, pretty good. Next one, what about this one? Hardly ever. Hardly ever. And we have 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 50-50. Let's see. She hardly ever sees her family. ¿Qué se me hace? ¿Qué se me hace? Que algunos pusieron, her family hardly ever sees she. No sé por qué tengo ese presentimiento. No. Pero, teacher, pero así diría que la familia casi nunca la ve a ella. Sí, pero no. ¿Por qué no? Porque si yo quisiera decir eso, entonces no diría she, sino que dijera her. Pero her es possessive adjective, teacher. No en este caso. Acá es lo que llamamos un object pronoun, right? Un pronombre objeto, que funciona como cuando yo digo que voy a ir, voy a salir con ella. Digamos, voy a salir con ellos para que veamos la diferencia. So, I'm going out with, y aquí no pongo ellos, they, sino pongo ellos, them. I'm going out with them. Voy a salir con ellos. So, por ahí un día de estos les voy a explicar un poquito más a fondo lo de los, esto de los object pronouns, porque sí es bastante importante. So, por ahí lo vamos a repasar. All right. So, there you go. So, let's see. And let's see. So, we continue. All right. Positions changing. So, Meli, Carla María, Yuli, Carlita Lanza, and Evelyn. Next one. All right. What about this one? This one might be different. And time. So let's see. This is different. This is the verb to be. So it's not an action verb, right? So remember, if we have the verb to be, then we use the frequency adverb after the verb to be. So you are sometimes late for class, right? So remember, we follow this pattern or this structure just with the verb to be. If it's an action verb, it's all the way around. So there you go. Next one, let's see. All right, Julie, going to the first place. Carlita Lanza, Evelyn on fire. We have Meli and Carla Maria. Next one. What about this one here? Mark. So let's see. 3, 2, 1. So there you go. In this case, action verb. Mark often sings In the shower. There you go. Let's see. Same positions. Evelyn on fire. Next one. Put the words in the correct order. What do you think? This is a tricky one. Five, four, three, two, one. Ay, 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 ay. 50-50. So here we have the verb to be. So remember, if we have the verb to be, boom, the frequency adverb goes after. So we say, she isn't usually mad at us. Mal no solo significa loco o loca, ¿verdad? Sí significa eso, pero no en este caso. Acá es enojado o enojada. So ella usualmente no está enojada con nosotros, right? So there you go. Let's see. Julie on fire. Evelyn. Carla María. Carlita Lanza. And Melly. Let's see, number 8. R. Three, two, one. So we have, very nice. There you go. So they are always correct. Excellent. Same positions. Evelyn on fire. Almost there. Number 9. What about this one? Indie films. So we have 3, 2, 1. Let's see what happened here. Ay, ay, ay. Indie films are usually boring. So, verb to be, right? Indie films, yes, okay. ¿Qué son indie films? ¿Son películas de la India? ¿Cómo es eso? No, right? Películas independientes, de ahí el indie, right? Independent. So, independent films, que es cine independiente, right? Que no es comercial. So, they are usually boring sometimes. See, Julie still in the first place. Carla Maria going up. Evelyn, Melly, And Carlita Lanza, the last one. Let's see. What about this one? So let's say 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ay, 50-50 again. So let's see. Here we have he hardly ever, remember? Hardly ever. It's together. I mean, that's the way we make that frequency adverb. Casi nunca, no? Hardly ever reads a book. So, final scores. Third place, Millie. Second place, Carla Maria. And the first place, queen of frequency adverbs, Dule. Very good, nice. Special mentions to Evelyn and Carlita Lanza, fourth and fifth place, respectively. Round of recap, nice. Excellent. All right, all right. Viene con todo, Julie. Nice. Okay, perfect. So, here we have. Here we could see two of the most important, let's say, ways to use frequency adverbs. If I have an action verb, it goes before the action verb. If I have the verb to be, then it goes after the verb to be. So, golden rule, don't forget that, okay? So let's see. Now, one more practice. Now, let's see. We're going to work now in, let me see. Let's say groups of three people. So, what are we going to do? I'm going to share with you a link for a little exercise. Just give me a second. Okay, so there you go. So I'm going to share it in the chat here. There you go. Okay, so what's the exercise about? It's pretty simple. Here, you're just going to order the sentences that we have here. Here I have 10 sentences, and you're going to do pretty much the same that you have been doing or that you did in the exercise just now. So, really simple. Once you finish this, then you're going to click where it says terminado and enviar mis respuestas. Then you type the three names, name of the people who were working in the team, course, B2, subject, English, and my email address that I shared with you yesterday as well, rolandstone06@gmail.com. Simple. So I'm going to give you a couple of minutes for you to complete this. Then we're going to have one more practice about this, but I'll explain to you that once we are back. So here we go. Group number one, we have Angel, Carlita Lanza, and Meli. So you're group number one. Group number two, I have Glenda and Obed. Group number three, Josue, Carla Maria, and Lucy. Group number four, Iris, Vilma, and Julie. And group number five, Anita, Marilyn, and Evelyn, all right? So I'm opening the breakout rooms right now so you can start working on it. I'll give you more or less 10 minutes for you to finish, and then we come back and I'll explain to you the next activity. So let's see how you do it. If you need some help, just let me know. Ya le voy a compartir el link por WhatsApp. So let's see.
Teacher, a mí no me metió en ningún grupo.
Quiero ver, Emilio. Sí, está en el... Perdón. No, se quedó fuera. Quizás se había desconectado, creo. Lo voy a incluir en el grupo 5. So, ahorita le va a caer la invitación, Emilio. And let's see, Lucy. Okay, ya entró. All right. Porfa, también le mandé invitación para que trabaje con el grupo 1. piece of cake. Nice. Okay, so let's wait for the rest, okay? They are going to be back in some minutes. Good. Let's.
Teacher, just a question.
Yeah, tell me.
And about the homework, the audio practice for yesterday, mm-hmm. and I'm sent to you this night.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah, I was just checking that I got
it. Is that a problem, too late for sending homework?
It's 2 points less, right? Nah, just kidding. No, no problem.
Okay. Okay.
Nah, no problem. That's okay. So, okay. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you for sending it. Nice. Okay, so almost everybody here. I guess everybody's here now. Let's see. Yes. Okay then. So let's see. Let's just check here this little exercise that you completed. So let me see.
What about teacher?
Hello.
No le hemos terminado porque estas letras no se quieren quedar en el cuadro. Estamos batallando.
Oh, you have problems with the words. A veces es de allá del lado. So yeah, I know. Se ponen difíciles.
Okay. Lo mismo nos pasó.
Okay. All right. Creo que a veces hay que ponerla justo en un lugarcito ahí en el cuadro para que se quede pegada. But let's see, I'm sorry about that. Okay, so, y tal vez entonces, en lo que terminan, y, well, let me see, ¿le faltaba mucho?
Sí, es que de ya rato estoy batallando y por la 4, vamos.
¿Y lo hacen del teléfono o de la computadora?
Del teléfono, porque nadie tiene computadora del
bus. Ya. Pues por eso, quizá un poquito más, más difícil. That's okay. All right. Y don't worry, me la pueden mandar despuesito. So, don't worry, okay? So, this is just a little practice. So, let's check it together just to make sure that we are actually getting the idea. So, what about, let me see, in number one. So what do you think is the correct answer? Let's see, Anita, number one. Anita. Hello, Anita, not there.
Sally, Usley.
Hello, Anita.
¿Me escucha?
Yes.
Sally.
Ajá.
Usually. No.
Goes.
To.
Uh-huh. ¿A dónde se va Sally? Anita. Anita. Ajá. Casi no le escuchamos, Anita.
To bed.
Ajá.
10 o'clock.
At, ajá, at 10
o'clock.
Very good, nice. So Sally usually goes to bed at 10 o'clock. Nice. Let me see. Next one. Josue, are you there? Josue. Not there. Josue, lo perdimos a Josue. Let's see. It is number two.
Ahorita, espérame.
Okay, okay.
Number two.
Uh-huh.
He sometimes eat uh-huh. for breakfast yogurt.
He sometimes eats. Aquí ponemos lo que va a comer. He sometimes mm-hmm. eats
yogurt breakfast.
Ajá, yogurt.
For.
Ajá, for breakfast. There you go. He sometimes eats yogurt for breakfast. Nice. What about number three, Orfa?
Diga.
Hello, Orfa. What about number three?
La tercera, bien.
Yes, en la vencida. No.
Mary.
Aha, uh-huh. Mary.
Mary does not. Mary does doesn't.
Aha. Uh-huh.
Often.
Aha. Uh-huh.
Wash.
Mm-hmm.
TV in the morning.
All right. So, de veras que no se pegan estas letras.
TV on the morning.
So, very good. Mary doesn't often watch TV in the morning. Nice. Thank you very much.
In the morning.
Good. What about number four? Let's see. Who else do I have here? Vilma.
Okay, teacher.
Let's see.
Bueno. Julie.
Let's see, Julie.
Never. Go.
Go.
No.
I don't know.
To.
Julie never go to. Julie never go to you.
In the park.
In the park. No. What about number four? What's the correct order? ¿Será que tal vez no estamos hablando de Julie? ¿Que tal vez no es Julie? Ajá.
It's July.
Very good. It's July. So we're talking about the month, es el mes, right? De julio. Sonó ahí, quiero ver. So, si fuera Julie, ¿qué nos hubiera dado la pista? Que el verbo hubiera estado con ES. Julie never goes. Pero uh-huh. dice go el verbo. Entonces, uh-huh. el sujeto tendría que ser you.
You.
So, you never go to...
In. To
the... Uh-huh. You never go to...
In the park.
In the park.
To the park?
You never go...
You never go to the park?
Park. In July.
In July? Or in July?
In July.
In July. In July. There you go. You never go to the park... In July. So, tú nunca vas al parque en julio.
Julio.
There you go. Nice. So, very good. What about number five? Let's see. Ovid.
I.
Uh-huh.
Or I don't always.
I don't. Always
play
computer
games.
Computer games, very good. So I don't always play computer games. Nice. What about number six, Lucy?
Number six, she does often homework after school.
Does often homework after school. She does often.
Sorry, she often does.
Ah, homework. There you go. Excellent. She often does homework after school. That's the thing. Excellent. Nice. So let's see. Next one, number seven, Julie.
Dígame, yo estoy todavía. Porque yo lo estaba llenando del grupo batallando. Y alguien me está ayudando, pero como no salimos.
Oh, that's okay. ¿Cómo cree que quedaría las siete, Julie? What's the order?
Kevin, sometime. Ajá.
Kevin sometimes takes
the bus to school.
The bus to, the bus to school. There you go. So Kevin sometimes takes the bus to school. Perfect. So let's see. What about number eight? Carla Maria.
They usually
yes
don't drink coffee.
They usually don't drink coffee. There
no,
you
no.
go. Uh-huh.
They usually don't drink coffee. Yes.
Yes. All right. So, well, here we have. Here we have this. Yeah, ya sé por qué dudo. All right. So what do you think, Carla María? ¿Lo dejamos así?
I think va en medio, ¿verdad? El adverbio, ¿verdad?
Mm-hmm. Yes, very good. Yeah.
Tenía la duda.
There you go. Coffee. They don't usually drink coffee. Se oye bonito. They usually don't drink coffee.
Es que el don aquí no es tanto como un verbo, sino que como el auxiliar.
Exacto. Very good. Nice. Yes. Usualmente, si no tuviéramos ese don't aquí, sí diríamos they usually, ¿verdad? Creo que de ahí es que nos agarramos ahí de que sonaba bien. Pero sí, tiene razón. Va el auxiliar, luego el frequency adverb y luego el verbo principal. So, good. Nice. So let's see. What about number 9? Millie. Millie. Not there. Si no, seguimos con...
I'm here, Ana. I'm here.
Ahí está. Okay, let's see. Millie.
Okay, number...
9.
Number 9.
My dad always
brushes
his teeth. Very good. So, my dad always brushes his teeth. Nice. Good. And the last one. Let's see. Carlita Lanza.
Hola. She never eats burger for lunch.
She never eats burgers for lunch. Perfect. So there you go. So this should have been the way in which we had to order these sentences. They were all action verbs. So we didn't have, in this case, examples with the verb to be. So this is just for you to get familiar with this specific structure with action verbs. And also whenever we use auxiliaries, like in the negative case of certain verbs. Nice. Okay, there. Now, let's see. If you check on page, let me see. I don't know if you can see my screen now. Let me just share it one more time, because I'm not sure. Let's see, here we go. Okay, so if you check page 20 in your books, there you're going to see a little box, like a little box with activities and some frequency adverbs there. So you're going to have a little homework for tomorrow. This homework is going to be actually completing this square or this box with your own information. Uh-huh.
Una pregunta, ¿por qué sale mala cuando nosotros ponemos en las preguntas que acabamos de pasar, often?
Espérame, me perdí. ¿A dónde? ¿Qué número, Julie?
Aparece en la 3, en la 6 y en la 8.
En la 3, en la 6 y en la 8. Uh-huh. ¿Cómo los puso? ¿Cómo puso la 3?
Mary often does.
Doesn't often.
Acuérdense. Vaya, pero en la 6 está doesn't often y me salió mala.
En la 6.
En la 6.
No es auxiliar. En la 6 es un verbo principal. Does, acuérdese, puede ser un verbo auxiliar o un verbo principal, que es hacer. Cuando es auxiliar, no tiene traducción. Cuando es un verbo principal, es hacer, como en hacer la tarea. She often does homework after school. Así la tenía.
She doesn't often homework after school, sí.
No. La número 6.
She does often.
No. She often does. Ajá. She often does. Y en la número 8 era igual a la número 3. Ahí sí. They don't usually drink coffee.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Bueno,
nice. Okay, there you go. Nice. Acuérdense que Si es negativa la oración, vamos a ocupar un auxiliar. Si es un action verb y es negativo, vamos a ocupar doesn't o don't. Si queremos meter un frequency adverb en una oración negativa, lo vamos a meter en medio del auxiliar y el verbo principal. Por ejemplo, el número 8, they don't, auxiliary, frequency adverb, usually, verbo principal, drink. So, así nos quedaría. Pero, como a veces do y does, también pueden ser el verbo hacer, ahí sí sería un verbo principal, como en la número 6. Aquí digo hacer la tarea. Y entonces, como acá es un verbo principal, pongo el frequency adverb antes de mi action verb, como hice con los demás, como si tuviera ahí eat, o write, o read, etcétera, etcétera. Lo consideraría entonces un verbo de acción. So there you go. Nice. Okay, sorry. Now coming back to this activity. La actividad en la página 20 la van a completar con su información. Dice, complete a list of your activities you do in a regular week. Pero esto va a ser, ustedes lo van a presentar de manera oral. Okay? Ustedes nos van a hablar de su, de las actividades que ustedes hacen en una semana, ¿no? O durante la semana. Van a ocupar los adverbios que ya están acá. Y always, often, sometimes, hardly ever, or never. Y prácticamente eso, ¿no? Ustedes solo van a llenar o solo lo van a acoplar a sus rutinas que tienen entre la semana. Remember, esto no es solo escrito, esto lo van a presentar mañana. Nos vamos a tomar un ratito para que ustedes nos cuenten sobre esas rutinas o sobre esas actividades que hacen durante la semana. ¿Ok? ¿Preguntas con respecto a la tarea? ¿No? ¿We cool?
We only go to present to the class, or it's necessary to send you to the email?
No, you're just going to present it. So the important thing is that you actually speak about it, right? That's the important thing. Nice.
Sí, ya solo vamos a escribir, dijo, lo que hacemos siempre, a menudo, a veces, nunca, de las actividades.
Ajá, la van a escribir, o sea, que van a hacer oraciones de su rutina o de lo que hacen en la semana y lo van a presentar mañana en la clase. No me lo van a mandar escrito, lo van a presentar de manera oral.
Ok, gracias.
Nice. Ok, pasamos lista. Entonces, por última vez, let me see. De acuerdo a la lista, let me see. Ahora se quedaría Mauricio Emilio. Emilio, tiene... unos minutitos después de la clase.
Sí, claro.
Sí, nice, excelente, Emilio. Good. Sí. Ok, so nos quedamos entonces y yo paso asistencia en I'll let you go. So, number one, Alison Gabriela Ramos no está acá. Y next, Ana Beatriz Pineda.
Present.
Thank you very much, Anita. Y next person, Ángel Balmore Aguilar.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Angel. Next, Brenda Raquel Reyes, que no está acá. Next, Glenda Marisela Cuellar.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Glenda. Next, Iris Beatriz Cornejo.
I hear.
Thank you very much. Iris, next, Josué Vladimir Alvarenga.
Present, teacher.
All right, thank you very much, Josué. Then we have Carla María Beatriz Arana.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Carla María. Next, Carla Yesenia Lanza.
Present.
Thank you very much, Carlita. Next person, Lucy Nathalie Juárez.
Here, teacher.
Thank you very much, Lucy. Y next, Marilyn del Carmen Solís. Marilyn, creo que tuvo problemitas por ahí. So we continue with Mauricio Emilio Alvarenga.
Present teacher.
Thank you very much, Mauricio. Next person, Obed Alexander Alas.
Here, teacher.
Thank you very much, Obed. Next, Orfa Lisette Barrera.
Here.
Thank you very much, Orfa. Next person, Rosa Vilma Landa Verde.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Vilma. Next, Sonia.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Evelyn. Next, Teresa Guadalupe Bonilla, que no está acá. So we have Jessica Melissa Oya.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Meli. So last but not least, Julissa Raquel Cruz.
Present, teacher.
Nice, thank you, Julie. Okay, so there you go. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, as always, a pleasure for me to be here with you. Have a good night, get some rest, and I'll see you tomorrow. So have a good night, people.
Bye. Good night, teacher.
Bye bye.
Good night.
Sweet dreams. Take bye. Care. Bye bye. Bye. Okay, let's see. Okay, Emilio, ahí estamos. So, ¿qué tal? ¿Cómo has sentido las clases después de la vacación que tuvimos?
Pues muy bien, solo que el viernes anterior. Ajá. Se me acabó el internet cabalito en el momento cuando iba a pasar la segunda asistencia.
Híjole,
No, yo pensé que nada, y quedó dando vuelta, dije, a lo mejor la señal, no, hombre, ya nunca cargó.
Híjole, ya no se pudo conectar, vea.
No, ya de ahí ya no, y de ahí todo bien. Sí me cuesta la pronunciación, porque, bueno, como es que tengo años de que no pronuncio, bueno, no, sí, años de que no, ni por cerca pronunciaba el inglés sin leerlo, sin pronunciarlo, pero... Pues ahí solamente eso sí, la práctica. Y a veces cuando me queda poco chance, me pongo a escuchar canciones en inglés para ver de un poco, o leer para... Pero igual, cuando leo no tengo problemas porque no entiendo. Entonces, igual me pongo a usar el traductor, pero igual hay veces que el tiempo con mi trabajo casi no da. Pero es lo que hago, trato de traducir palabras para... Bueno, ahorita me cambiaron de cocina a bodega y he optado por las cosas que tengo, ponerles el nombre en español y en inglés. Entonces, pues ahí sí, no se me olvida cómo se llama lo que tengo, porque igual tengo en español y en inglés. Ajá. Para recordarlo diariamente, hacerlo como una rutina.
Nice. O sea que usted antes trabajaba en cocina.
Ajá, yo soy chef. Entonces... Ajá. Entonces estaba en un restaurante, pero faltó una persona, el encargado de bodega del mismo restaurante. Entonces pasé a la bodega.
Ya.
Entonces, ahora lo que ahí he optado por tener ya etiquetados todo lo que es la materia prima de inglés y español.
Entonces, mire qué bien.
Tiene que quedárseme porque igual, cada vez que voy a acercarme, digamos, voy a traer una bolsa, voy a traer un tenedor. Entonces, lo tengo en español y lo tengo en inglés.
Súper, mire qué buena técnica. La verdad que bueno que se haya ingeniado, digamos, esa técnica para hacerse más fácil. O sea, relacionarse con lo que usted maneja, ¿no?
Sí, porque el problema es ese, que como yo tengo tiempo de que no... Que, bueno, es que prácticamente el inglés siempre lo vi como algo de para qué, pero vi el anuncio en Facebook y dije, no, pues me escribo y pues ya voy por el segundo módulo.
Sí, y pues bien.
Y pues igual me gusta, no sé, sí lo había tomado como algo que no, pero pues habiendo la oportunidad, pues hay que aprenderlo y en la vida cotidiana es necesario.
Sí, la verdad que sí, es bien útil. Y uno nunca sabe, o sea, a dónde lo va a llevar la vida uno y si pues, alguna vez lo va a tener uno que utilizar, que ocupar en alguna circunstancia.
Sí, porque viene un producto que está en inglés, pues igual me toca aquí irme al traductor. Entonces, si ya sabiéndolo, ya es un poco más menos complicado.
Ajá, correcto. ¿Y en qué empresa trabaja?
Inversiones Leslie en San Miguel. Inversiones Leslie para Restaurante Los Poblanos y Restaurante Los Leslie. Pero prácticamente yo pertenezco a Poblanos, porque como lo dividimos en dos, somos una sola empresa, Inversiones Leslie, pero Restaurantes Leslie y Restaurantes Poblanos. Entonces yo soy Restaurante Poblano.
Ah, ya. Ajá. Me suena.
Estamos en la ruta militar, estamos al frente de la tercera brigada. Y en el metro centro estamos al frente, al nomás entrar, ahí pues está la fuente. Y el restaurante Leslie, que será amarillo, está en la entrada de Super Selecto. Está un poquito atrasito de Poblano, el que le llamamos Poblanito porque es más pequeño. Entonces está casi a la par. Una farmacia lo divide.
Ah, pues sí. Por eso creo que me sonaba, porque está en metro.
Ahí estamos.
Ya. Ah, pues sí.
Y ahora me trasladé de esa parte, ahora me he trasladado a la parte de atrás, que es donde tenemos la planta de producción, donde producimos la materia prima para los tres restaurantes.
Mire, qué bueno, qué bueno. Ok, bueno, sí, súper, Emilio, eso que ha hecho está bastante bien. Y yo, como les digo siempre a todos, ¿no? Cada quien tenemos como nuestras ramas, tenemos nuestro trabajo, sabemos lo que hacemos. Algo que siempre nos puede ayudar un montón. En teoría, lo que hacemos nos gusta, ¿no? Entonces, es como de, voy a buscar algo que tenga que ver con mi trabajo, con lo que yo hago, cómo se dice tal cosa, así como ha hecho usted con los productos. Puedo tal vez buscar, en su caso, puede buscar como tal vez frases de atención al cliente, para preguntarle X cosas a la gente, ¿no? Expresiones que se utilizan en la cocina, diferentes palabras que se ocupan también al momento de cocinar, las medidas, ¿no?, que uno utiliza a la hora de hacer las recetas. Todo ese vocabulario le puede servir a usted, pero un montón, Emilio, en su trabajo. Como le decía, uno no sabe qué es lo que puede suceder luego. Usted que es chef, por ahí a veces he visto que salen oportunidades que se van en los barcos, ¿no? Los chefs.
Lejos, sí. Sí, no, amo mi familia. Amo mi familia. No. Ya me salió.
Ah, de verdad.
Sí, pero no, un crucero de, no sé, que a los 3 meses parece que iba a regresar. Solo con eso me asustaron.
Huecho, tío.
No.
No vaya a ser, tío.
No, hombre. Reniego cuando me ponen 2 días seguidos que a salir noche, no, hombre.
Ya.
Solo sí, por 2 días, imagínate. Sí. Imagínese, ¿no? 3 meses, no, hombre, ni siquiera.
Otro nivel, va.
Sí, no. Chivísimo. Voy a ganar como cuatro veces lo que gano acá.
Pues, pero sí, no. Es bastante, pero, ajá, sí es matado, pero me imagino. No. Y sacrificado. No ver a la familia 3 meses ya es un buen rato.
Me asustaron, eso fue lo primero. No.
Sí, Sí, tal vez ahí para alguien que no tenga familia, que tal vez, no sé, vea, le podría funcionar, pero ya uno con su familia ya es complicado.
No.
Ok, nice. Bueno, Emilio, pues prácticamente eso, ¿no? Seguir empapándonos de vocabulario. Creo que con los temas que vamos ahorita, prácticamente hemos estado... Vamos un poco despacio, todavía vamos repasando algunos temas del módulo anterior.
Del módulo 1.
Ajá, si se fija ahora, pues vimos un tema del módulo anterior, pues lo vimos como con más detalle, como que lo desmembramos un poco más para hallarle el uso correcto a estos adverbios de frecuencia, por ejemplo, que fue algo que mencionamos el módulo pasado, pero que no estudiamos tan a profundidad, ¿no? Y todavía estamos con el presente simple. Creo que todavía entonces no tenemos mucho problema. Y más adelante ya vamos a empezar a ver otros tiempos. Ya dentro de poco comenzamos con el presente continuo, por ejemplo. Así que nada, no es de echarle ganas de ponerse las pilas y ahí vamos, Emily.
Y ahí las oraciones también para, vaya, como para armar palabras. Si usted me da palabras para, así como las que acabamos de hacer, eso sí se me complica, porque yeah. El inglés es complicado. A veces que lo inicio al de último, o lo de último de en medio. Entonces, para ubicar palabras, también en eso tengo problemas.
Ok. Acuérdense que la oración...
Y los números que nunca se me,
que no le
nunca se me quedan. Siempre me lo repaso y me acuerdo cuando lo voy repasando, cuando voy en el autobús. Cuando ya no, ya se me acuerda, ¿no? ¿Cuál? Mejor lo digo en español y ahí muere.
Sí, es de memorizarlo. Ahí sí no hay de otra, Emilio. Ahí sí es de...
No, único que...
Buena memoria. Pero...
Tener buena memoria.
Pero poco a poco, sí, poco a poco.
Sí. Ahí, vaya, lo que noto, trato de hacer es, vaya, para armar palabras, o cuando me toca que leer algo en inglés, porque igual, yo sé que cada palabrita sí entiendo qué dice. El único problema es para formarla, cuando, vaya, casi inglés es algo, es como por lógica. O sea, no es a lo que va primero, ni cual, sino que usted lee qué es cada cosa y dice, ah, no, pues tiene que decir de esta manera. Aunque aunque usted la lea al revés, porque puede ser que diga que los rojos son los plátanos y son que los plátanos están rojos, entonces todo es al revés, pero usted hace la lógica y dice, ¿cómo va a ser? O sea, para el español, ¿cómo voy a decir que es a lo contrario? Entonces, y ahí es lo que he tratado de ser un poco lógica.
Sí, a veces traducimos o queremos traducirlo directamente al español y es lo que nos complica el orden de todo, ¿verdad? Pero...
Ajá, porque nosotros escribimos de otra... Ajá. Ajá, nosotros lo... O sea, para mí, yo lo encuentro como que yo lo escribo, nosotros los españoles lo escribimos ordenado, y el americano lo escribe desordenado, y para ellos... Pues igual, nosotros somos los desordenados.
Cuestiones de la gramática, ¿verdad? Pero... Poco a poco, ¿no? Con el tiempo nos vamos acostumbrando, creo que a darle el orden correcto a la oración. Es cuestión de irse acostumbrando, de ir agarrando
práctica. Ajá, con eso. Las palabras, cómo se ubican y ya.
Exacto. Pero ahí vamos, poco a poco. Yo sé que se va a ir acostumbrando más. Ahorita todavía estamos empezando el módulo 2, pero ya en unas 2 semanitas más vamos a ver qué tanto hemos progresado, Emilio.
Ahí se va a ver la diferencia. Sí, ojalá que sí. Pues es una de las ideas y tratar de, pues, aprender cada día más y pues es todo.
Correcto. Es de echarle ganas, Emilio. Así que, bueno.
No hay otra opción que...
Sí, no hay de otra. Pero bueno, gracias entonces por igual quedarse estos minutitos para poder tener un poquito ahí de feedback. Y pues nada, adelante, sigue así, creo que vamos bien en su caso, así que solo sigue así, ¿no? Pónganse las pilas y cualquier cosa, ahí estoy a la orden.
No, pues gracias a usted y a todo el grupo de Inglés Corporativo, de que pues es una oportunidad, imagínense cuando yo en mi casa ahorita y así no tengo que faltar de mi trabajo, más que tengo una señora de recursos humanos que es súper complicada, que para que me dé la autorización, ay Dios mío, y que roncarla lo más posible. Pero ahí
vamos.
Pues se echó y a decir que sí, pues sí, es lo importante de que sí dio la opción, ¿no? Porque pues ya para este módulo pensé de que no, porque a último momento me escribió, pero gracias a Dios al fin terminó diciendo que sí, pero es lo importante.
Qué bueno. Bueno, entonces, pues lo dejo. Emilio, gracias por su tiempo. Y pues por ahí nos veremos mañana entonces.
Bueno, okay. Gracias a ustedes también y feliz noche. Bueno.
Gracias, igual. Have a good night. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.